Hollywood legend has it that on first meeting this charming actress, Louis B. Mayer declared, "Deborah Kerr. It rhymes with star." Deborah Kerr became a household name in Britain during World War II. By 1944, MGM acquired a stake in Kerr's career, with the intention of making her an international star.
I wish that Italian fellow were alive, Leonardo. He knew how to paint a woman like you.
Though MGM chief Louis B. Mayer thought highly of Kerr and her talent, he already had another attractive red-headed Briton in his stable of stars, Greer Garson, a major box office attraction for MGM. Mayer reportedly saw Kerr as insurance in case Garson left MGM, but Kerr was in a class of her own.
Him, this is Mrs. Dorrance.
Oh, oomph!
Oomph, it sounds like Yogi or something.
Deborah Kerr and Greer Garson were never rivals. They even worked together in 1953's Julius Caesar. Despite any gossip, Kerr and Garson got along splendidly.
A gala event in Hollywood. Deborah Kerr takes the spotlight at the Photoplay Magazine Gold Medal Awards, receiving from Steve Allen the coveted award as Most Popular Actress of 1957.
Through the years, her strong, dramatic performances on stage and screen earned her many awards, including 6 Oscar nominations. Her first was for 1949's Edward, My Son.
I don't see things the way you do anymore. I've suddenly woken up and I'm frightened. I'm frightened for my son.
But Kerr was equally adept at light comedy.
Honestly, we never dreamed there'd be this much fuss about the oil leases. But first Iraq, then Iran, now Pakistan is in the act. Well, thank heavens I'm a woman. A man couldn't take it.
Deborah Kerr. It still rhymes with star.